Recently, I did an update on Binance Triangular Arbitrage Finder and it received significantly higher views compared to the other two videos that I did. So I thought maybe the community is interested to know more about this Arbitrage Finder. So I thought, why not build this tool for some other exchange? So that's what I did. I built the same tool for Bybit Spot Exchange. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to set it up, how to install, and some key differences between Binance Spot and Bybit Spot in terms of arbitrage. So let's get started. Now let's look at some key differences between Binance Spot Exchange and Bybit Spot Exchange in terms of triangular arbitrage. So on Binance Spot Exchange, as of now, we have around 380 trading pairs and 14,480 arbitrage paths. Whereas on Bybit, there are 319 trading pairs and 348 arbitrage paths. So now you might be wondering, how come both the exchanges have almost same number of pairs, but Binance has significantly higher number of arbitrage paths? So the reason that is the case is because Binance offers several base markets. For example, on Binance, you have USDT market, BUSD market, BTC, Ethereum, and you know, and XRP market. And you know, it offers so many base markets. Whereas on Bybit, there aren't that many markets. From what I saw, you have BTC, USDT, and a few other markets. So because there aren't that many markets offered by Bybit, the amount of trading, you know, arbitrage paths are, you know, significantly less. And if you compare the coin market cap rankings of Binance and Bybit, Binance being the top crypto exchange, it has around 10 billion trading volume every day. Whereas Bybit, it currently ranks number 7 and it has around $276 million of trading volume every day. Now, this is an important factor because if on an exchange where there is high trading activity, it's an indicator that the market is already pretty saturated and the likeliness of finding an arbitrage opportunity is very less. Whereas Bybit, because it is not ranking on the top, it's likely that the markets are not that saturated and the possibility of finding arbitrage opportunity is slightly higher. That is one of the reasons I chose, you know, Bybit might be a good exchange to build arbitrage bot. Now, there are a few other reasons why I chose Bybit, but we'll talk about it towards the end of the video. Let me first show you how to install and set it up. Now let's look at how to download and set up the bot. Now the code is deployed as a public repository on GitHub. That means it's totally free to use and anybody in the world can download and access it. Now to download, you need to hit the code button and you see an option to download the zip file. Now after you download the zip file, you need to extract the zip file. After you export the zip file, you need to open the contents of this folder in a text editor of your choice. I'm using VS Code, but you don't have to use VS Code. You can use any text editor of your choice. After you open the contents in VS Code, this is how the folder looks, and you can look at each individual file. Before we go ahead and run the bot, I want to take some time explaining how the code is structured and how it's different from the Binance bot that was previously built. Now let's look at the code. We're not going to look at each and every single line of code. Instead, we'll try to understand the code at a high level. Now, this index.js file is the first point of entry. And you can see here that all we're doing is create an express server and running it on port 3000. And when we run this file, we're just serving a single HTML file that's present in the pages folder, this index.html file. That's it. And when we open this bot in the browser, this index.html file is going to serve and display on the browser. And we use that to display all the arbitrage opportunities that are calculated by this bot. Now, if you open this arbitrage.js file, that's where we have the key code to identifying the paths and doing the arbitrage calculation. So if you expand, you know, the code in the arbitrage.js file, and you'll find there are three functions over here. So first one is get pairs. So when we first start the bot, this is the function that's going to get called, and it's going to identify, you know, all the available symbols and the arbitrage paths from the available symbols. And towards the end of this function, we're just going to log to the console the total number of symbols and the total number of paths. That's it. And once we identify all the paths, we're going to establish a WebSocket connection. Now, this is where this code slightly differs from how we implemented in Binance. So the good thing about Binance is there was just a single topic that we have to subscribe to that provided the bid and ask information of all the assets. Now, that is not the case with Bybit. In case of Bybit, we have to subscribe to this bookticker topic, for all the available symbols. So there are around 319 symbols at the moment. So we have to subscribe to all the 319 book ticker topics for all these symbols in order to get the best bid and ask information. Now, there is a limitation as to how many pairs you can subscribe at any given time. So if you read the documentation, you'll find that we can only subscribe to a maximum of 10 topics at a time. So because there are 319 pairs on the exchange, you would have to divide all the pairs into chunks of 10 and then subscribe to 10 topics at a time. So that's what this code does. So we just divide all the topics into chunks of 10 and we subscribe to one chunk at a time to avoid, you know, exceeding this threshold. And once we do that, all the connections are established, and that's when we start receiving the bid and ask information of all the pairs, which is what we're going to use to calculate the arbitrage, you know, profitability of each arbitrage opportunity. So that's it. Now let's install the necessary dependencies and run the code. Now, in order to install the dependencies and run the bot, you need access to the terminal. Because I'm using VS Code, I have access to an inbuilt terminal in VS Code where I can run all the commands. But if you do not have VS Code installed, you can still go to the folder where you have your contents unzipped, do a right click and click open in terminal. That should give you access to the terminal and you can run the same commands over there. But because I have VS Code installed, I'm going to run the commands from VS Code. Now the first thing we're going to do is install the dependencies with the command npm install. That's it. The packages are installed and you should see a folder called node_modules, which indicates that the packages have been installed. Now you can clear the console. Then we're going to start the bot using the command node_index.js. We're going to see a set of instructions in the console. So let's go through it one by one. So as I explained earlier, when we first start the bot, this get pairs function is going to get called, which is going to identify all the available arbitrage paths from the tradable pairs. It's going to take a while to run this. Yeah, it's finished. So you can see that there are around 319 symbols and 348 arbitrage paths. Then it's trying to establish the WebSocket connection to all the 319 book ticker topics. And like I said, it's doing 10 chunks at a time, and you can see the progress over here. It shows the number of connections that are pending. Again, this step is going to take a few minutes. Once all the connections are established, you can open this URL in your browser to access the tool. Now, this is what I see when I open the URL in the browser. Again, it looks very similar to the Binance Arbitrage Finder, and you will see all the opportunities over here and the identified profit. Before I wrap up the video, I want to mention a couple of things as to why I chose Bybit as the next exchange to build the triangular arbitrage bot. Now, before you continue watching this section of the video, I suggest you to watch the recent video that I did on the Binance Triangular Arbitrage. In that video, I mentioned a couple of things as to why I couldn't build an automatic trading bot. Now, one of the issues is that we cannot just rely on the best bid price and the best ask price to calculate the triangular arbitrage profitability, because the higher, you know, as we increase the position size, our buy price is going to increase and the sell price is going to decrease, thereby diminishing the overall profitability. Now, the only true way to capture this is to take order book into account while calculating the triangular arbitrage. Now, because Bybit has so few pairs and, you know, so few paths, I think there's a possibility of locally storing order book for each and every pair and then take that order book into account for calculating the true buy price and true ask price, which makes the overall calculations for, you know, triangular arbitrage more accurate. Now that we resolve this issue, I think it makes sense to go ahead and add an auto trading feature where, you know, whenever an arbitrage opportunity is identified that exceeds a certain threshold, like 1% or 1.5% or 2%, then, you know, we can go ahead and execute 3 trades in succession to capture this opportunity. Now, I still think there is a risk in, you know, executing this trade, because Because you know the order book data changes on a millisecond scale. So by the time you execute the trade, the order book can be completely different, and you know the prices at which you execute the trade can be different, and you know your overall trade might still end up with a loss. But I want to give it a chance. I want to build this feature on top of it and see if it's really possible to, you know, make profits. But like I said, once I build it, I'm going to make it public and I will let you guys to try it out and see if it really works. So I'm going to continue making videos on arbitrage bot for Bybit. So this week, the bot that I'm releasing, it's pretty similar to the one that we have on Binance. But I'm going to make two more videos. In the next one, I'm going to show you how to incorporate the order book data into this bot and make the arbitrage opportunities more accurate. And once we do that, in the third video, I'm going to show you how to implement the auto trading feature on top of it. I think it's going to be exciting, and I'm just as eager as you to see how this goes.